Good morning.
Now, I've seen a beautiful box of chocolates in the window with an Easter message, but what I'm really after are Easter eggs. Gosh, that rabbit is amazing. The Easter eggs are beautiful, but they are, if I may say so, rather expensive, aren't they?
Well, they are, of course, filled with our delicious chocolate assortment, which we make all the chocolates in our factory at Stratford, London E15.
Those ducks are really pretty. Where do you have those made?
These are made by one lady exclusively for us, and she lives down in Essex. And she makes the boxes also on the rabbits and the lace eggs.
Beautiful lace eggs with sort of jewels on them too.
Yes, beset with jewels and filled with Charbonnel's delicious assortment of chocolates.
Leaving everyone else busy preparing for Easter, I went with Matt to meet Alf Allen at the chocolate factory. Hello, Alf. Right, I've got my clothes on to keep my hair and everything out of the way. What have we got here? What's it to make?
The ingredients for making a vanilla caramel.
Uh-huh. And what are they?
The first ingredient is water, sugar, glucose.
That is very solid, Alf.
It is a nice thick glucose, that one. Nucleine fat, which is a vegetable fat, creamy butter.
So once you've got all these ingredients together, you cook them.
Yes.
How do you do that?
In the copper pot behind you.
Why copper?
It's a better conductor of heat.
Now, once you've done that, what's that over there?
That is full cream milk.
Milk? It doesn't look like milk, Alf.
Oh, it is, yes.
Oh, it's condensed milk.
It's full cream condensed, yes.
Now, why don't you add that before the cooking?
Well, if we added that with all these ingredients, we'd finish up with a burnt caramel.
Hmm.
Because the minute the milk goes into the caramel, you've got to keep stirring it, otherwise it burns.
Right, and what's that in the test tube? It looks very scientific.
This is your vanilla flavouring, which is also added at the end of the cooking.
How are those stoves powered, Matt?
They're powered by gas for a more direct heat for certain processes.
And do you cook anything else in those copper pots?
Yes, we do. Fudges and also the roasting of Brazil nuts.
Actually, while we're waiting for that to boil, could you tell me something of the history of the company?
Yes, it was Mademoiselle Charbonnel and Miss Walker, who were ex-premiers de la Maison Boissière de Paris, came over to Old Bond Street in 1875.
So you've had a shop in Old Bond Street for over 100 years.
That is so.
Now, you have a royal warrant, a by appointment. How long have you had that for?
For 15 years, President. When the caramel is thoroughly cooked, it is poured into trays to cool and set. This is going through the cutting machine. And there is a machine that has fail-safe devices. It is then trimmed. The edges are trimmed off there. It is turned round to go back through the machine in the opposite direction so that it is then cut in squares. As well as these caramels, we also make fondant creams.
Right, now you have your fondant mixture, but how are you going to flavour it?
Well, first of all, we're going to colour it pink.
Right.
As we're making a rose cream,
we've got to... And then, that doesn't affect the flavour, does it?
Oh, no, we add the rose Otto flavour.
There's hardly any of that there.
Well, that's true, but it's because it's such a strong flavour that you need just a little minute amount.
And once that's all mixed together, you...
Now that is ready for running.
Do what happens here. Right. So the next thing is this?
Yes. Stick in the pot.
May I help?
Please. Four.
Four. Two. Three, four. It's quite heavy stuff, isn't
it? It is, yeah. That's the correct amount now.
This looks a very old-fashioned way of doing it, Alf, with a stick. Is that just to, stop the constant flow?
All the creams made by hand are done this way.
It's fabulous, but it looks very skillful. How long has it taken you to learn this?
Well, it depends on yourself entirely. If you've got a fairly steady hand, it shouldn't take all that long.
They're just sort of left in here as a mould, and then to dry?
Yes, after about 15, 20 minutes, you can take them out and have them going through the machine to be coated in chocolate.
Now, it is my turn. Ooh. Hey, I've done one. Ooh. I don't think I'll get a job, Alf. Certainly not on piecework.
You're doing well. You've only got two now. You're taking the stick out too much.
Oh. Oh, it's a bit mean.
Basically, there are five kinds of chocolate centres: caramels, fondants, fudges and nuts, and marzipan, which we can see here being cut into shapes using an ordinary pastry cutter. From this stage on, all the centres are taken to be covered with chocolate.
And what's that machine called?
This is a chocolate enrober, and here you see them going through the pre-bottoming section of the machine before passing on to the refrigerated part of the table where the bottoms are cooled. And then going on through the curtain of chocolate where they get completely covered and another coating on the base.
It's like a sort of chocolate waterfall. I think my mouth is watering. Now, what's going on here?
This is a little girl marking the chocolates. Each one has a different mark on tops for identification. A very skilled job, and she's very fast at it.
Hey, they're painting with chocolate now.
They're coating the molds for fish and Easter eggs with chocolate before putting them in the refrigerated cabinet for cooling. They come out cool, and they're demolded in one piece, as you see.
But why fish?
Fish is an old French festival to do with early April and Easter.
I don't believe it. They're at it with their brushes again. What's going on?
These are very, very special camel hair brushes, very expensive. And they're very soft, and they bring up a shine on the chocolate.
Ah, the packing process. That's an enormous box in the front there.
Yes, the biggest in the trade. That is a bois blanche, or white box, and it holds 10 pounds of chocolates.
Now, that's the message going in, isn't it?
Yes.
Have you ever had any mistakes?
We have, yes. One dear old lady on the eve of a major operation received the wrong box. It said, bon voyage.
Oh, dear. Who's going to receive that box, Matt?
Ah, just you wait and see.